Good morning, all of you. I am your science teacher. I am going to teach you science. First, before starting our chapter, I want to ask a question to you. When we going to purchase the vegetables, when we purchase tomato or brinjal or maybe we purchase banana, always we select the pieces. Why? And what is this process? The selection of the process. What is this? This process is separation. And why do we need the process of separation? And why we need to separate the substance from the other? Because always we want good food or good useful substance and remove the impurities or the waste substance. So today's our topic is depend on the same topic. And our fifth chapter is separation of substances. So today we discussed some different separations, need of separation and where we need and why this is useful. Okay. So when you prepare tea at your home, always we separate the tea from the tea leaves. Why? Because tea leaves is not useful for us. And we need only tea liquid. So we separate the tea leaves from the tea liquid by the strainer or by the sieve. Okay, same time when we harvest our crop, we always separate the grains from the stalks. Why? Because stalk not useful for us and we need only grains. So we separate it. And the same time, if I give you some in a bucket, I give you some mangoes and guava, and I told you that you separate both type of fruits in different buckets. So what you do? Easily you pick the guava in and put into the different bucket, and put the mangoes in and put into the separate bucket. Okay. So by this process, by the hand picking, we are able to separate both of the fruits. And if I give you the mixture of salt and sand, can you separate it? No. Why? Because these are the small size particle. Mango and guava is a large size material or large size of particle, so we are easily separate by hand picking. But salt and sand particle are of small size, so we are not able to separate by the hand picking. So different separating method we use to separate the things. Okay, so different method we use for the different types of substance. It is depend upon the size of the substance, state of the substance. Okay, so different methods are there. In daily life, many times at many places you always use the separating methods. For example, when you eat poha or dalia, some persons don't like the chilies, so they pick the chilies and out from the plate and throw from the plates. You see it? Yes. You most of the students or many students from you also do that. So here in your book, our table is there. We are giving some separation process and the purpose of the separation, why we separate, what is the purpose of the separation, and what do we do with the separated components. After the separation, there are two or three separating components are there. What we do with that? So, in this table, second and third column are jumbled. So I arranged it. We are discussed with the arranged table. So there is the first point is separate stone from rice. This process all persons have seen that, and you also see in your house. Separate stone forms rice. And what is the purpose of it? To remove non-useful component. This process is used to remove the non-useful substance, that is stones. Stones we don't need to use. So we separate the stones from the rice. And what do we do with the rice or the stones? We throw away the solid components. It means stones. We separate stone from the rice and we throw away the waste stones or the substance. And the second, churning milk to obtain water. The process of churning, while the process of churning, we obtain water from the milk. In third chapter, we already discussed it. So by the churning on the basis of centrifugation, butter is come on the top layer on the basis of their density. So we separate the butter from it, and the remaining part, that is also useful. So purpose of separation, why we separate butter from the milk? To separate two different but useful component. This process is used, and the purpose of the separation is we use both the substance. Butter we use in another condition, and the remaining part we also use in another condition. Okay, and what do we do with the both components? We use both the components. We use butter and we use the remaining part of the milk also. And the third condition, separate tea leaves. Why we separate the leaves from the tea? What is the purpose of it? To remove the waste or impurities. To remove impurities, because tea leaves are not useful and it is like an impurity. So what do we do with the tea leaves? We throw away the impurities. We throw away the tea leaves. Okay. I hope you will understand. If you have any doubt, you can ask. Good luck.